Hello, I'm Dena Jacquay, Parkview's Chief Administrative Officer, and welcome to another episode of Parkview Connections. It's a podcast geared to help our community and Parkview coworkers connect, learn, and grow in leadership. So today we are at Humane Fort Wayne, honored to be here with two really important ladies. One, Jessica Henry, who's the Executive Director of Humane Fort Wayne. And we also have with us a special guest, Melissa McKown, who is our Vice President of Employer Solutions here at Parkview, but also Vice Chair, correct, of Humane Fort Wayne, and has a really rich history within this organization. So we thought it'd be great to hear from both of them today.
Thanks for being here.
You know, thank you for having us. So, Jessica, let's start with you. So tell us a little bit, just for those that may not be familiar with Humane Fort Wayne.
Sure.
So give a little background.
So Humane Fort Wayne is the merged name of what was the Allen County SPCA and Hope for Animals. And a couple of years ago, those two powerhouse organizations became one. And the reason we did that was so that we could better serve both pets and people in this community. So we have an animal shelter. We have pet retention programming, which we can talk a little bit about later, but we also offer affordable spay, neuter, and wellness for the animals in our community and outlying communities as well.
Where does the passion that you have for animals come from?
Well, I think that first of all, I've always been an animal lover, and you know, I always say you either love dogs or cats, and if you don't love either, nobody loves you. But I have always loved animals, and I've always been, I think, a social worker at heart. So for me, this is a marriage of those two philosophies that I love so much, which is helping animals and helping people. And when I'm able to, in the adoption realm, find a wonderful home for a pet, or if I'm able to help pets through our pet retention programming, or whether it's what we do here at the clinic, those are things that feed my soul. And this organization had had a lot of opportunity, I think, when I first got there, for us to make real strides in the saving the lives of animals in Fort Wayne and Allen County. And so this board let me do just that. And the success that we've had has bred more success, and that's made me love my work even more.
Well, and I know we recently saw in the news here that you're expanding.
Yes.
New facility. Can you maybe say a few words about that?
Sure. So again, we've been in this community for 70 years, and for the last 40 of those, we've had an older retrofitted location on the corner of Hannah and Pettit, and then we have this location where we are today at 1333 Maycrest. Both of these buildings have been well-loved and well-used, but all that program expansion that I talked about has really meant that we've needed a bigger space for us to do what it is that we do so well. So we purchased some ground near the University of St. Francis, and we are going to build a 25,000 square foot facility that will house our shelter, our clinic, and it'll have an education center, which of course is very important because we want to be able to teach this community what it is that we do, and we want to share this knowledge that we have with other shelters as well.
You know, there's so much, particularly the last several years, there's so much around well-being and a focus. And when you think about that special bond between a pet owner and their animals that they love, there's a lot of science that goes around just the well-being. And we at Parkview are all about inspiring and helping people with well-being. Can you talk a little bit about how just the services at Humane Fort Wayne and how that ties into well-being?
Sure. Well, I think we all saw it, especially during the pandemic. Everybody went out. If they did not have a pet, they went out and got one. And it is because animals provide for us that companionship that we all need at any given point in time, but especially when we're all at our loneliest. For me, it's very personal. When my dad passed away, my mom's pets were what kept her going every single day. And so when I first got to Humane Fort Wayne, we did not have a lot of programming beyond pet adoption. And so I wanted to expand into, again, that realm of social services to be able to help people keep the pets that they have. So how do we do that? Well, we have a robust pet food pantry service now that we are able to do pet food pop-up distribution all over the region, right? We also offer in-home services, which is volunteers from Humane Fort Wayne going into the homes of pet owners who might be struggling a little bit to care for their animals. Maybe they're older. Maybe they have some physical limitations. So our volunteers, they're there to help them care for those pets so that those pets can stay where they are, where they're loved, and where those people have that companionship that they so need. We also offer a terrific program called Compassion Foster. This is for the pets of people who are in personal crisis. Think house fire, think victims of domestic violence. Think hospital patients who might refuse to have hospital admission because they've got pets at home and no one to care for them. Humane Fort Wayne will take those animals in and provide temporary emergency foster care for those animals so that people can recover from whatever crisis they're currently facing. So those are just four programs that we offer, but we are always thinking, how do we provide affordable veterinary care for folks, again, so they can keep their animals at home? No shelter wants more animals, more homeless animals. No domestic violence shelter wants more domestic violence in the community, right? We don't want more homeless animals. What we want are animals who are loved in the homes where they are. And so how do we protect that pet, that human-animal bond? We do that through our pet retention programming.
There's so much. First of all, you exude passion. So love everything that you're talking about and how you've expanded so many services. But you can see it's a real labor of love for you, certainly personally. When you mention the hospital, I mean, that's just an interesting, when we think about, yes, we have individuals coming into our ER and they perhaps have to be admitted into the hospital. And to think that there is an opportunity for them if they don't have someone at home to care for their pets who they're worried about, mm-hmm. and who's there to take care of them, that this is an alternative. And that's just a great way for us, certainly here at Parkview, how can we help get that word out? Because there are individuals that might choose not to have the care they need simply because they're worried about their companions at home.
Or long-term rehabilitation if they have an orthopedic surgery or something and they might not want to have that because they don't have anybody to care for that animal for 6 weeks. That's where we want to make sure that we're helping to keep that bond in place.
Oh, that's really good. Melissa, so you've been with Parkview a long time. And it was a surprise to me. I had no idea that you not only played the role that you, of course, do at Parkview, but what you've done within Humane Fort Wayne, and you're the vice chair now, but you have such a rich history. Where does your love for animals come from?
So we've had animals my entire life, so I've always had a passion, but I did not understand really everything that could go on in a community as far as the need for more shelters, more rescues. But what brought me here is that we had a huge euthanasia issue back in 2008 when I first got involved. We were euthanizing 10,000 animals a year in our community, and that just broke my heart. And it really came down to not having affordable spay-neuter and enough of it, really. So that was where I got involved. We had a hole. So we had the SPCA that was handling the rescue part, and we had, you know, many, many people helping on that side. And then also the Fort Wayne Animal Care and Control was very involved as well, but there was a gap. So that's where I came in and used really my business background and my passion for starting something new, entrepreneur at heart, and it was a perfect marriage for me, gave me a little bit of a side gig outside of Parkview. And also just, you know, my Parkview family and community was very helpful and resources and so many animal lovers at Parkview that I had a big support system.
Well, Melissa's going to be too modest to tell you that this facility, since she opened its doors, has spayed or neutered more than 100,000 animals in this community. So that is a huge, really, all accolades to you for having that vision and having the gumption to reach out to your Parkview family to help make this happen, because that you cannot adopt your way out of pet overpopulation. And so kudos to you and the others who made this come to life, because it really has been one of the most life-saving initiatives in this community's history.
You know, when we were on the tour earlier this morning, there was a doctor who was here, and she just had her 100th
Thousand surgery.
Mm-hmm. Who was that?
So she was really our founding veterinarian. And Melissa, you can speak to it because you're the one who hired her.
So Dr. Carol Fretz, she was actually at the ground level with us when we first opened Hope for Animals back on June 1st of 2010. And so now, 13 years later, she just hit her 100,000th surgery. And she has just a huge passion for our mission. And, you know, not many veterinarians would give up their private practice to come work in shelter medicine. And she's just been instrumental in getting us where we are today. So she's amazing.
Well, and just not only being able to meet her, but the passion you talk about, I saw mm-hmm. that here this morning with everyone
Absolutely.
That we've been meeting, to the volunteers and to really seeing the team that come together every day. So there's a lot to be proud of. So this podcast is a lot about leadership, and we like to kind of share around what leadership advice that people have had and that really has meant something to them, and really imparting some of that to future leaders or leaders now who want to continue to grow. Jessica, what's been some of the best leadership advice that you've received?
I think I want to, as a leader, give my team the freedom to fail. That's been given to me. Our current board chair learned some advice from a leadership trainer she'd had years ago, and she shared with me that mistakes can be a good thing when you learn from them. And so this board has given me the grace when I have made mistakes, but that's also then given me the freedom to fly, right? And so I want to extend that same grace to all of the team members here to try new things, because if they don't work, you can always go back to the way things used to be, because it's pretty successful as it is today.
And I think just that whole experimentation, try it. Mm-hmm. If it doesn't work, you can go to something different, or you can go back to, as you said.
That's right.
But not trying, you're not going to be able to advance
That's
forward
right.
without trying.
That's right.
Melissa, what about you?
Well, you talked about passion. I think as a leader, we need to encourage everyone that is in our organization to find their passion. And whether that's in the community or in the work they do, like Jessica said, just encouraging people that there is no failure.
So you talk about that passion. I mean, recently we rolled out, Jessica, what's called volunteer time off at Parkview.
Oh, that's great.
Volunteer, maybe it's at your child's school, maybe it's for a nonprofit. And so this is a great, how you got started in some of this work, and now being able to, our coworkers going out and finding places that they want to serve and find that passion, not only in the work that they do for Parkview, but out into the community mm-hmm. and really the broader impact that we can have in the region. So love and applaud that. I think that's great.
I love and applaud Parkview doing that, because we need volunteers here. I speak on behalf of all nonprofits that we can't do what we do without volunteers. So hats off to Parkview.
Shameless plug for
yeah, perfect.
On the website,
that's right.
Our volunteer application.
That's right.
So Melissa, one more thing for you. So you're the vice chair of the board, and we've not had that angle before. We've had a board member here, and I would love to get your perspective. What does board leadership mean to you?
Well, it's interesting, because when I started Hope for Animals, I had no board experience, but here I was creating a nonprofit and then eventually becoming board president. And I think that was my role, is to help break down those barriers and just say, what do you need? And let them take their passion and run with it. And now as vice chair, I don't have quite as active as a role as I used to as board chair of Hope for Animals, but with the new combined board, I think, you know, my leadership in that case was the merger, mm-hmm. you know, really taking the two organizations and realizing that we can act better as one and be so much stronger. And I think our community has so many nonprofits that it's something that our community could learn from, just that maybe you can combine forces and be better together.
Yeah.
This is a great example of nonprofits coming together and advancing and growing in the community mm-hmm. in just such a big way. Thank you for the tour this morning. And it was great to talk with both of you just around the journey. And good luck on the new building. We're
Thank
excited
you.
To
yes.
do a podcast after that building opens.
From that new education center.
That's right.
Yes.
So looking forward to it. Good luck with that.
Thank you so much. Thanks for being here today.
Happy to. Well, it's been a great morning here at Humane Fort Wayne. And thank you for tuning in to another episode of Parkview Connections. If you're interested in learning more about the capital campaign for the new facility, being a volunteer, donating, and also just looking at the services. If you are a pet owner and you want to hear more about the services offered here, please visit humanefw.org, and we'll include the website as well. And please continue to provide. Today's suggestion of being at Humane Fort Wayne came from one of our coworkers. And so we continue to appreciate the recommendations that you all have about the different visits and community organizations that you want to hear more about. So please continue to do that on Pulse for coworkers or on the YouTube. You can leave a comment as well. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next time.